Okay, we're a couple of weeks from the start of hurricane season. Yes, it's true. You know, it's always a good idea to pay attention to what the forecasters are saying.
People like our Mike.
Yes.
Felicia, Sandra, Eric. But as our Kathleen O'Toole reports, there are some other groups in our community who know a thing or two about the weather.
He loves to be scratched in behind the ear.
He weighs more than your average meteorologist, and Lion Country Safari director Terry Wolf says that's exactly why this massive white rhino can feel the rumblings of a storm a long way off.
They can detect thunder, any vibrations in the soil.
The native birds at Lion Country have been known to fly the coop a full day in advance of a hurricane. Yet it's the reptiles at the park that are the best weather forecasters.
Well, at least 24 to 48 hours ahead of time, they'll know.
The Burmese python, the gators, won't eat if a storm is coming.
If we feed her before it happens and then she senses it, she'll spit that food back up because she knows she won't be able to digest it.
And it's reported that Aldabra land tortoise can give almost a seasonal forecast, having the ability to hold off laying fertilized eggs. They taste the soil and nest when the temperature and humidity is right.
They need about 100 to 110 days of good weather for these eggs to hatch. Water turtles are particularly good at kind of telling us if we're going to have a flood and how high up they lay their eggs on the bank.
It is a myth.
Chris Lancey of the National Hurricane Center has heard that one before.
Turtles have the same senses that we do, and if they had some way of knowing in advance, that'd be wonderful, but no, there's no way that turtles can forecast where a hurricane is going to occur months later.
Hit the water at Grassy Waters Preserve to see what the apple snail knows about rainfall.
6 weeks. Yeah.
6 weeks out.
Yeah.
That's pretty impressive.
Pat Painter says a clever little snail lays its eggs 6 inches above the water line, but predicts that level weeks out.
They're usually way ahead of us as far as indicating, you know, what the levels are and what they should be.
Even the vegetation is known to tell tales.
You know, the Seminoles used to claim that you could tell something about the sawgrass when it would bloom. If it started laying down, a big storm was coming.
Well, what do you know?
Well, you know, back in 1926, the Seminole Indians tried to tell the white men in Miami that a hurricane was coming because they read the signs. They read what was going on in nature. They hightailed it, and the Great Miami Hurricane hit. It was a Category 4 hurricane. So there's something to be said, but you know what? I'll stick to my radar. I'll stick to my computers.
Do we need to start scratching you behind the ear like the white rhino?
Can't hurt.